The Godfather, Deer Hunter, Raging Bull, Taxi Driver, Goodfellas. I could go on and on. All incredible movies that made Robert De Niro one of the best known people on the planet. And of course, the legendary actor that he is. He's still making movies, but in recent times, we've seen him bring politics to the fore more. His strong criticism of the president at the Tony Awards was explicit. We all remember it. And Mr. Trump hit back. And now we're seeing a recurring role on Saturday Night Live as Robert Mueller.
I have something for you.
Is this a subpoena or your final report?
No. Report? No, no. It's a picture of my grandson. I've been spending so much more time with him since I don't have to investigate some idiot for treason.
Wait, it sounds like you know I used to be president.
Oh, I know everything. Everything.
Let's bring in the man himself, Robert De Niro, joining me live from New York. Thanks so much for being with us. I think if 2 years ago someone had told me you'll be interviewing Robert De Niro, first of all, I would have been thrilled, full stop. But you'll be interviewing Robert De Niro, who's playing a special prosecutor investigating the sitting president for possible collusion with Russia during a presidential campaign. We live in a, we just live in a crazy world.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I never thought in my lifetime, and I've seen a lot in my lifetime, I never thought, I was working out with my trainer the other day, and we've seen horrible things over the years, but this is one of the worst that I have ever seen and that I ever, as I say, ever thought I would see. But it's real.
But why are you so vocal about it, though, at this stage in your career? Because you've been very outspoken against the president.
I know what kind of person this guy is. He's a New Yorker who I never would want to meet. Never want to meet him, and now he's president. And the reason I wouldn't want to meet him is because of the kind of person he is. As we all know now, there's nothing new. It's disgraceful, but we'll get past it. It'll be one of those things, it'll be like a nightmare that you remember. I'll be with my trainer, we'll be 5 years from now saying, remember all that stuff, how terrible it was, and at least I live to see the time when this will all pass, like any nightmare.
But so you've called him stuff like, that you've called him a national disaster. You said F Trump at the Tonys.
I meant a national.
You called him a bozo.
I'm going to interrupt you.
No, I was just going to, go ahead.
I was quoting someone, I'm just having a block on the name, he calling him a national disgrace.
Right.
Not a national. He is also a national disaster, too, but he was a disgrace. It was a disgrace. When I said that, it was before he was elected.
Some people have criticized you.
It was Colin
even when
Powell who
profanity.
I quoted.
So. Yeah. And do you think that possibly you're basically giving him what he wants by just keeping this, by kind of creating a feud with him where he then replies on Twitter and says you're a low IQ or whatever, you took too many blows to the head, that in a way you're kind of playing his game?
No, because even his responses, his retorts, if you will, are inane and they're kind of stupid. He doesn't say anything that's even witty or smart. So it doesn't bother me. It's ridiculous.
But you're playing Mueller on SNL. I watch it every week, and it's whenever you come out on stage, you immediately get this incredible just round of applause. What made you? How did that come about? Playing Mueller on SNL.
I think it was I think my wife had mentioned. We were talking about what character could I play in all of this? And I think she said, well, what about Mueller? And I called Lorne Michaels. I said, Lorne, what about playing Mueller? I think that's how it happened.
Mm-hmm.
Is it something you're
having fun with?
I'm having fun with it, yeah. I mean, I love Saturday and SNL. And so it's that part of it is always fun to do.
So all these ideas that come from the Trump administration that you don't like, we're seeing some of them take hold in our part of the world. So we're seeing, for instance, with Brexit, or just now I interviewed the Hungarian government spokesperson, these kind of populist ideas. Is that something you think about at all, like what's happening outside of the U.S., this kind of ideological wave outside of the U.S., and what do you make of something like Brexit, for instance?
Well, I don't know fully what Brexit is, but I have a sense of what it is and what I've been told and what I've read and so on. And people are dissatisfied with certain things. The working people, the people who are getting not benefiting from like the rich in this country who with Trump with his tax breaks and so on, it all boils down to giving the rich a break. And I think that happens in other. The working people both on both sides, right and left, are concerned and angry, and they have to be part of the equation of making things right. I mean, it's easier said than done, but it has to be. Yeah. And I think that's what it is. But I hope they have a referendum in England. That's my feeling, because maybe they'll change that, and maybe that'll be better. I don't know all the things, so I'm not really qualified.
It looks like it could be heading that way. But let's talk movies. I have to say, for me, this is such a thrill, because when I was a teenager, I saw The Deer Hunter on. I was raised in Paris, and there was a movie theater that showed, older films on the big screen. And really, I think that's sometimes the only way you should be able to watch a movie. So I saw The Deer Hunter. I think I was 17 or 18 years old, and I can say with confidence that it is one of the movies to this day that has touched me the most. And when I cannot believe that I'm speaking to you now, actually, the actor that touched me and moved me so much. You're collaborating, this was not a Scorsese movie, obviously, but you're collaborating with Martin Scorsese, and Al Pacino is co-starring with you in a movie called The Irishman, and that's coming out next year. Can you talk to us about that? This will be your 9th collaboration with Martin Scorsese?
Yeah, it started about over 11 years ago with a book called I Heard You Paint Houses, which is really what the title will be. Everyone refers to it as Irishman, but it really, that's the title. And I think that Marty wants to use that title, which I like better, really, though The Irishman's a good title. And it took it many years. We were about to do another project of the same kind of subject. And then it was a genre about a hitman, but a more popular kind of story, not really specific. This is a much more specific, it's very specific about the Hoffa, Jimmy Hoffa's killing and so on. So Al Pacino plays Hoffa. Joe Pesci plays a character named Russell Bufalino, who was a big part of all of this. And the three of us are very close as friends. And I don't want to give it away, I suppose. But anyway, then you'll see. Is that,
and it's a
is
Netflix,
that okay, what I said?
No, absolutely. But I'm interested also in kind of how Netflix and these streaming platforms are kind of like the new... It's the new platform for some of the best TV and movie making out there, which is a very new development. I mean, what do you make of that development? Because TV series, I don't know if it's something you'd be interested in doing. It's kind of become the higher art form almost now.
Yeah, it's they're working it out where, I mean, like a movie like I Heard You Paint Houses, The Irishman, should be put out in a big venue, a big theater in places, certain cities, and then it can be shown later and whatever, like any movie these days. But that's important, and I think that they're working that part of it out, at least in the beginning. It opens in a grand way, especially a movie that we've done. And they're smart enough to know that Netflix, the details about when and how long, and so I don't know yet.
So it will be in movie theaters before it streams, basically.
Yes, that's my understanding. Okay. I don't see how it could be streamed.
Would you be interested in doing a kind of a TV series now, and we're seeing these huge celebrities and big-time movie actors doing television now.
Well, many things in television are better. Better quality and so on. And I'm working on something with David O. Russell. We were working on something, but because of the whole Amazon Weinstein Company thing, that got kind of put aside. But mm-hmm. we have another big project that we're working on, and it'll be, again, a Netflix project, and maybe it will be open in theaters if it feels that's the way it should be first presented. They could mm-hmm. do that. I don't know yet.